Even great games can always be made a little bit better, so here's another must-have mod. The Hammer of Grungni is a mod for Total War Warhammer 2 by Grey Tiger Games. One of the bigger complaints from longtime Total War Warhammer players is that the base game factions always seem to get the shaft. Every DLC adds new and interesting unique mechanics to their lords, but if you happen to be one of the starting four, you're always stuck with the same old bit of boringness. Grey Tiger Games is ready to change that. By adding a rune smithing mechanic for all dwarf factions and a unique mechanic for each of the dwarf legendary lords. The heart and soul of the Hammer of Grungni mod is the rune word forging mechanic, which is available from the very start of the game, and has each lord craft a variety of bonuses using the new forge system. For those unaware of Dawi lore, dwarfs don't take much stock in magic, and instead depend on mystic runes to enhance their daily lives. To create a new rune word, the player just has to click on the runes they want, one from each category, and then these runes will be added to the bottom of the screen. Then you click craft, and the rune word is created and assigned to the first free rune word slot. All crafted runes last for 10 turns, and you can have as many active as you have rune slots available. If you craft a new rune word but have no slots available, it will overwrite the one with the least number of turns remaining. When creating a rune word, there's also a bonus effect added, and is a different stat based on the combination of runes. Gold runes are offensively oriented, blue runes are defensive, and red runes add utility, things like leadership buffs. Normally, you'll have to pick one from each category and then smack them all together into one great rune word. You unlock new runes and rune words by taking additional dwarven settlements in the name of the Dawi. But now let's talk about the individual mechanics each lord gets. Belagar Ironhammer receives a new Ancestral Renown mechanic that provides upgrades to the combat abilities and buffs players, lords, and heroes. It also comes with a new UI element added to the campaign screen. Renown is earned from winning battles and is tracked on the bar. When the player gains enough renown to move on to the next tier, the bar is updated and the tier's combat stat bonuses are unlocked. But besides just buffs to heroes and lords, you can unlock several army abilities for use on the battlefield. These include debuffs for opponents, roots to keep enemy units in place, a healing spell, and a destructive barrage called Ragnarok. Ungrim Iron Fist, the Slayer King's mechanic, revolves around looting and defeating beasts in monster hunts. The player then has 15 turns to locate the beast's army and defeat them in battle. The monster hunt event pops up and provides the player with a clue to the beast's location, but unlike Imric's dragon encounter system, don't expect these to just pop nearby. You'll need to read the quest and it will tell you where to go. You'll need to go seek out a glorious death with a wandering army, as befitting a Slayer King. If you do manage to beat the army, then you are given the option of killing the beast to gain a new resource called Acclaim, or you can choose to tame the beast and recruit it into your army via the Regiment of Renown panel. The new Acclaim resource can then be spent on upgrades to Slayer units in much the same way as the Greenskin Scrap system. There are 6 beasts to hunt down total and slay or tame, depending on how you want to play your game. Normally, these are all unavailable to the dwarf roster, so it adds a good bit of fun, monstrous variety to your campaign. Grombrindal, the white dwarf too angry to die, has access to a new resource called Valor. It's gained from winning battles and can be spent on upgrades in the Valor Rewards screen, and is all based around combat bonuses, giving buffs to specific unit categories like infantry, rifles, artillery, etc. So if you want to hit hard and fast, he would be your dwarf. Thorgrim Grudgebearer's mechanic is the new Resources of Karaz Ankor, where the player can spend Oath Gold to unlock upgrades for specific unit types across all armies. Each upgrade has 3 tiers, which become more expensive as the tiers rise, and each tier is further locked behind a specific building requirement, generally focused on building the new masonry enclaves at important dwarf sites throughout the Old World. These masonry enclaves are part of the new stonemason's building chain added with the mod. It comes with 3 tiers, and at the maximum level unlocks a unique bonus depending on which dwarf hold you build them in. The mason chain also unlocks the new stonemason units. Unlike other units, Stonemason units don't benefit from a Dwarf Lord's redline buffs, and only the new Rune Word system and Stonemason chapters can help to improve their stats. The mod also comes with a smattering of new units, including Thunderer Marksmen, who have increased range, as well as units which can only be unlocked through a secret combination of runes. Put all this together, and you have an entire Dwarven rework in a mod, and exactly the sort of thing longtime players want to see added to the game. So if you're a fan of the Dwarfs, you owe it to yourself to check it out and to mark that grudge out of your book. This was The Hammer of Grungni by Grey Tiger Games, and this was another episode of Must Have Mods. I'll have a link to the mod in the description below, and links to Grey Tiger Games' YouTube channel, where he previews all his upcoming work, including a very exciting Bretonian Crusade mechanic I'll be keeping my eye on. If you have a mod you think we should highlight on this channel, make sure to leave it in the comments below. But in the meantime, don't forget to subscribe to see more, and thanks for watching.